Hey Math 3, welcome to our first online lesson. 10.5 covers making inferences about sample surveys. So we're going to be given some sample surveys and we're going to have to make some inferences about it. This is going to be our first use of inferential statistics, which involves using a sample to draw conclusions about a population. Recall in 10.1 where we talked about populations and samples and parameters and statistics. Because we are using sample surveys, we're concerned about samples. And then the data that we can draw from it will be the statistics. Now, as long as your sample is representative of the population, we can use statistics to make reasonable predictions about the entire population. So this is what we need to keep in mind as we are trying to make inferences about populations using samples. For example, one, we're gonna start off by estimating a population mean. So this table here shows the number of coupons purchased by a random sample of 40 adult users of a restaurant discount service. We're going to estimate the population mean. Now, because this is a random sample, this sample is representative of the population. We can use the sample mean to estimate the population mean. Adding up all the data values, you'll get 1,452, and you're going to divide it by the size of the sample, which is 40, and this will give you 36.3. So the sample mean will be used in place of the population mean. So using the sample mean, we can say the mean population of coupons purchased for all adult users is about 36. For example 2, we're going to be given several surveys in which the sample is chosen from randomly selected members of the population. And in this example, there's going to be various sample sizes in the samples that are used. In general, a larger sample size will produce more accurate estimates. So larger sample size is better. I'll make a note of that. Larger sample size equal to more accuracy. In example 2, a cafeteria manager wants to predict the number of chicken sandwiches that will be sold when students can choose between a chicken sandwich and turkey burger. 7 cafeteria workers conduct surveys of randomly selected students. The students are asked whether they will buy a chicken sandwich. The results are shown in the table. As we can see, the sample size varies between all the surveys. This column tracks the number of yes votes, and this column tracks the percent of yes votes. Let's focus more on the percent of yes votes. In part A, based on the results of the first two sample surveys, do you think there will be more chicken sandwiches sold than the turkey burgers? So we're looking at the first two. Judging by the first two, 66.7% and 73.3%, much greater than 50%. So based on these two surveys, you would think that chicken sandwiches will be sold more often. Now we're going to look at B. Based on the results in the table, do you think there will be more chicken sandwiches sold than turkey burgers? Explain. So looking at the table, we can see that as our sample size increased, the number of yes votes actually decreased. Let's look at our sample size of 200, which is our largest. Recall, larger sample size equals more accuracy. So if we look here, around 47% of the 200 students surveyed here said yes. So I would say no. So here's my complete answer. No, as the sample size got larger, the survey revealed that more students said no. In our sample survey, 247% said yes. All right, so that's it for this lesson. Feel free to contact me via email if you have any questions.